Well, this is your devotional for Wednesday, December 9th, and we're in week 10 of my top 10 Bible favorite Bible passages. I might have a bonus one for you next week. We'll see. I might even go into a dozen or a baker's dozen. We'll see how that goes. But I know I have one more for you for next week, but we're going to look at a passage that I think is so powerful, so life-changing. And it's what's interesting is in this short little passage, we see four generations of spiritual heritage, four generations of spiritual growth. And so listen to these words from 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 and 2, and particularly in verse 2. We're going to see that, and I'm going to kind of show you a picture of what it looks like to walk in community on our spiritual journey. So 2 Timothy chapter 2, beginning in verse 1. You then, my son, and Paul is talking to Timothy. He's talking to him as a spiritual son. You then, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And here's the generations. And the things you have heard me say, Paul says, the things you've heard me say in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to reliable people who will also be qualified to teach others. In that little statement, there's four generations. And I just want to look at this with you. And one of the reasons this is one of my favorite passages in the Bible is because it paints a picture of the spiritual journey. We are not alone. I mean, obviously, God by His Spirit lives in us. We're in fellowship with God all the time. But we're also not alone as we walk on our spiritual journey. So here's the picture the Apostle Paul gives Timothy. He says, Timothy, I want to paint a picture for you of four generations of spiritual growth. So Paul says, I, Paul, as a spiritual mentor, poured into your life, Timothy. I poured into you. I taught you God's word. I invested in you. Now the things, Paul says, that you've learned from me. So generation one is Paul. Timothy's generation two. Timothy, the things you've received from me. He says, Timothy, I want you to invest those in reliable people. So that's generation three. Timothy is now spiritually helping people to grow in their faith. But Paul says, that's not enough. You invest in reliable people who will in turn teach others. That's generation four. So here's the snapshot. Here's the picture. Four generations. Here's Timothy living his life of faith. G1, generation one, the Apostle Paul, pouring into Timothy, helping him spiritually. Timothy is now growing in maturity, G2, generation 2. Timothy, you now invest in reliable people. You pour into them, generation 3, G3, who can in turn teach others also, G4, generation 4. In that one verse, 2 Timothy 2:2, remember that, 2:2:2, 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 2, it encapsulates the journey of a Christian. So what's that mean for me? It means through my whole spiritual journey, there's been people who have been pouring into me. Whether it was Glenn and Doug, a couple of college students when I was in high school. Whether it was Pastor Warren Burgess or Pastor John Shaw, two older pastors when I was a young pastor who poured into my life. Whether it's right now, whether it's Paul Cedar or Carl Overbeek, two retired pastors who I get on the phone with or on a Zoom conference call, and they challenge me and encourage me to grow in my faith. I have people, generation one, pouring into me. I then am growing in faith. I read the scriptures, I pray. I've got to be attentive to my own spiritual growth. But it's not enough to stop there. I then pour into my sons, Zach, Josh, and Nate, spiritually. I encourage them. Leaders within the church, some of you who I get a chance to invest in and encourage you to walk with Jesus. But that's not enough. You then take what you're learning about Jesus and you pass it on to someone else. And then that's it. Nobody else hears about Jesus, right? No, the point is, it's a progression where those people we pour into, they pour into others who pour into others who pour into others. And that's the way it's been since the beginning of the church. You are here today, and I am here today spiritually because someone poured into us. Now we get to invest in others who in turn pour into the next generation. Maybe it's a child or grandchild, the next generation in terms of chronology. Maybe it's the next generation, it's just somebody younger in the faith. But I want to challenge you from this passage to look and say, who's taking my hand and helping me grow in faith? Do you have mentors, spiritual mentors in your life? If you don't, get them. My two spiritual mentors right now, Paul and Carl, they didn't come and volunteer to mentor me. I asked them if they would. I knew I needed it. Do you have people mentoring you? Are you growing in your faith? Do you then in turn pour into other people? Volunteering at the church, working with students, pouring into your own kids or grandkids, but someone who's younger spiritually, do you invest in them and help them grow in faith in such a way that they can do it for someone else, who will do it for someone else, who will do it for someone else? Lord Jesus, this is our prayer today. That we thank you that for the people that have poured into our lives spiritually, parents, grandparents, people who become spiritual parents like Paul was to Timothy. We pray that we will keep growing in our walk with you to love you more and be closer and closer to you. And then we dare to pray, God, put a few people in our life that we can pour into spiritually, that we can read the scriptures with, we can encourage in their walk with you, Jesus, and also equip them to share with the next generation so it will go on and on and on, Jesus, until you come again. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this picture of four generations of spiritual growth. May we be actively involved in helping the next generation love you more. We pray this in your name. Amen. Well, thanks for joining me again this Sunday. Service is at 9 o'clock and 11 o'clock online. And if you're going to be online, come about 15 minutes early and see the virtual lobby. We have Jackie there, and she interviews people, talks with people. It's kind of a fun way to get ready for the service. So if you log on early, that's great. And if you want to be on our campus, be sure you register for the courtyard, or be sure you register for the parking lot. And even if you don't register, show up. We'll find a spot for you. But God bless you. We will see you Sunday for worship.